Class 8 History Establishment of Company Power Part 3 Now we shall learn Third Carnatic War. It was the 7 years war in Europe, and here in India also this fight continued between French and British. The British captured the French settlement of Chandranagore under the leadership of Robert Clive, and it was very strong battle of both the countries, and it took place the Avadish. So the battle is known as Avadish battle in 1760. In this war the French was defeated by British, and they lost Pondicherry in 1761. In Europe also war was going on between the European countries, America, French, so on. Then they there came the war an end by signing the Treaty of Paris in 1763. It was brought basically peace treaty through this Treaty of Paris, and both countries agreed to bring peace among themselves, and this treaty affected in India also. Now the British agreed to give back Chandranagore and Pondicherry back to French. However, they could only use these settlements for trading purpose only. French can set up factories, but they cannot administer or take control over the factory or the industry. All this will be seen by the British. It will be under the control of British. So with this, the French was not very happy, but through the battle they lost their power, and slowly they vanished from India, and the British took over these powers in their hand, and they came to the political power of South India. British acquisition of new territories in India. British came to India as traders. Later they established political power was a gradual process. The main cause was the Mughal kings fighting for the power and richness, the wealth, to have wealth in their kingdoms. The British East India Company had already planned its expansion in the Indian subcontinent, conquest of Bengal. Bengal included the provinces of Bengal, Bihar and Orissa. It was one of the richest provinces of India. The British established a trading post at Fort William to gain a stronghold in India, and it was helped by the Mughal Emperor Farrukh Siya, granted the East India Company a free tax for import and export duties of trade. The Nawab of Bengal supports the Britishers, and he announced a farmer or task saying that the farmer means no task, no need of paying tax for any goods while they move, or no road tax should be paid by the British when they move from one place to another with their goods, and it was especially for the British people. They took it this task free in a wrong intention. They could carry all the wealth and the material from India to their country without any tax pay. When the Aliwarth Khan came to know that they are losing the wealth of their state, he fought for it and fought for the right of taking the tax from everyone. But the British was not agreed with his orders. He tried his best, but he couldn't succeed his work. However, his grandson Siraj ud Daula, who not only reforced taxation but ordered the British and French to stop their drive of fortifying their trading posts, stop all this taking all the things were taken from the state. He tried his best to stop all this wrong doings of British. Fortify means becoming stronger or richer. The British are becoming richer and richer, and the empire, the Nawab, becoming going down. So they were trying to get back their wealth back to the Nawab. But in Britishers were very strong people. Robert Clay was very strong governor general in that time. So he fought with the Nawab and they recaptured Calcutta in their hand. Next one is Battle of Plassey in 1757. The armies of Suraj ud Daula captured Fort William, which was British property, and the British retailed fort again back to capture the capital of Calcutta under the leadership of Robert Clay. The commander-in-chief of Nawab's army, Miss Jaffer, dashed the Nawab when the British bribed him with the offering of him, making him Nawab of Bengal. Even though Suraj ud Daula had a very good army with them to fight with the Britishers, but the Governor General of the army was Mir Jaffer. He was not a good man. He was jealous about the Nawab, Suraj ud Daula. And the Britishers knew that they cannot win the battle. So what they did was, he got hold of Mr. Jaffer and told him they will make him the Nawab of Bengal and give him some money. So they gave him, offered some money also. So with that way, he was want to support the British to come to the power. Now the both parties met at the land of Plassey, and the Nawab lost his life. Miss Jaffer was proclaimed Nawab by the British, but he was mere puppet in their hands. This battle marked the beginning of British rule in India, as by now they secured free trading rights for themselves, and they asked the Nawab of Miss Jaffer to pay high revenue from their wealth. Sometime he gave revenue to the British government company, but later he failed to give. So since he was not getting the revenue of the wealth or the cultivation, they changed his power and put his son-in-law, Miss Qasim, as a governor or Nawab of Bengal. Now Miss Qasim, who tried to recognize the role of Nawabs in Bengal, He had formed his army on European models, abolished customs duties on internal trade, and organized the administration. This made Britishers very angry with him. Now again the East India Company decided to remove Miss Gwasim from the throne and reappointed Miss Jaffer as the Nawab of Bengal. A treaty was signed between the British and Miss Jaffer, which gave the British permission to issue their own tax or their own agreement to lead their power in India. That way they captured the entire Bengal in their custody. So they could move now South India to North India. This way it was the starting of the British administration in India. This is the first battle for the Britishers to take control over the entire country or entire India.